Welcome to Picture Healer Channel. This is Shi Tian. Today we want to continue the last part of the Purple White Flying Star Feng Shui. They are totally 8 charts based on the 8 house directions. And today we are going to look at the Gen house and the Li house. And the Gen house is a house sitting on the northeast side and facing the southwest. And the Li house is a house sitting on the south and facing the north direction. Here is the number 7 out of the 8 chart. It's a Gen house. And this is the location for the 9 flying stars. In the center, we have number 8. That's the earth element. And according to the 5 element relationship, each section creates a different energy. On the right side is the 5 element relationship, the generating cycle, the controlling cycle, and the related element of each of the 9 flying stars. The star in the center represents the main energy of this house. In the southeast is number 7, the metal energy, and the metal drains the earth. That's the number 8, the center flying star. So it creates a depleting energy. And in the south, it's number 3, the wood. And wood controls the earth, so it's also depleting energy. And the southwest is number 5, the earth. The number 5 is always a conflicting gate and a challenge in the chart. The number 6 is the metal energy, and metal depletes the earth, so it's a depleting energy here. In the west is the number 1 water element, and the earth controls water. So this area's energy is death, and the death is usually just a symbolic meaning. The northeast is the number 2 earth element, and that's the same element, so it's still a generating energy. And the north is number 4, the wood element. Wood controls the earth, so this is a conflicting energy. And the last one, northwest, number 9, fire. Fire generates earth, so it's generating energy. Next chart is for Li house, and we use the same 5 element principle. And the house energy is represented by the center star, that's number 9, the fire element. And southeast is number 8, earth element. Earth depletes fire, so it's a depleting energy. In the south is number 4 wood element, and wood generates fire, so it's generating cycle. And southwest is number 6 metal energy. And the metal is being controlled by the fire, so it's the energy of death. In the east is number 7, the metal element. Fire controls the metal. Metal is being controlled by fire, so it's the death energy. And the west side, number 2, it's the earth element. Earth depletes fire, so it's a depleting energy. And northeast is number 3, the wood element. And wood generates fire, so it's generating cycle. In the north is number 5, earth element. And number 5 always represent a conflicting gate or challenge. And northwest is number 1, the water. Water controls the fire, so it's a conflicting energy here. Next, we want to talk about the house chart and the yearly chart combination. If your house is facing southwest, you have a Gen house. And we can look at the combination charts here to know more details. And we will start with the southeast. The southeast star combination is 7 and 6. And 7 and 6 are both metal element, and it's a classic sword fight combination. It can be positive, meaning power and promotion and success, but also related to quarrel, fighting, legal trouble, and money loss, because there's a fighting and conflicting energy here. The way to reduce the metal energy is to add some water element, such as a salt water cure, because water reduces the metal element. In the south, we have 3-2 combination. The number 3 is the wood element, and it controls the number 2, the earth element. And the 3-2 combination is called bullfight. It's very similar to the 7-6 combination, the sword fight combination. It also means legal trouble, argument, gossip, fighting, or money loss. And to balance the wood and earth, we can add some fire element. And because there's a number 2 here, that's an illness star, so we should avoid any renovation here. The next one is southwest, number 5 and 4 combination. The number 4 is a wood star, controls the number 5 earth star, and that can mean money loss, illness, and accident, because the number 5 is a misfortune star. So we should avoid renovation here because of number 5 star. And if you want to balance the wood and earth element, you can add some fire element here, either color of red, triangle shape, or something with heat and light, such as lighting or candles. And in the east, we have star 6 and 5. The number 6 is a metal star, and it depletes the number 5, the earth star. And that also reduces the power of the number 5, yellow misfortune star. Both stars are not the tiny star in period 8, so their negative characters are showing more than the positive. So we should watch out for disease, accident, or money loss. And the traditional cure for number 5 star is the metal objects, such as metal bell, wind chime, or metal clock, and avoid construction here because of the number 5 star. In the center, we have number 8 and 7. Number 8 is the earth star, generates number 7, the metal star, and it indicates fame, money, and relationship luck. So this area is very auspicious. It's one of the best area in this chart. In the west, we have 1 and 9. The number 1 is a water star, controls the number 9, the fire star. And both 1 and 9 are auspicious stars and tiny star in period 8. So this combination can indicate festive event, wealth, and fame. But water and fire are conflicting energy, so there might be possible illness or unexpected events. And we can add some wood element here to balance the water and fire. In the northeast, you have star 2 and 1. The number 2 earth controls number 1 water star, and it indicates female overpowering the male. And the number 2 is also illness star, so we should watch out for any type of disease and also disharmony between couples or mother and son relationship. And we can add metal element here to reduce the number 2 illness star. In the north is star 4 and 3 combination. Both 3 and 4 belong to wood element, and both are not tiny stars in period 8. So it can bring possible financial trouble or relationship trouble. And watch out for wood type of disease in Chinese medicine. For example, the skin problem or liver gallbladder related disease. And to reduce the negative energy, we can add some fire element here because fire reduces the wood. The last one is northwest with star combination 9 and 8. The number 9 is a fire star and generates number 8 earth star. And this is a very auspicious combination because both of them are lucky stars and they are both tiny in period 8. So it indicates fame, promotion, festive event, wealth, luck, and all the positive energy. So this is a good area to set up your important rooms or set up money altar or office. Now we'll look at the last house chart. That's the Li house. That's a house sitting on the south side and facing north. We will start with southeast, that's star 8 and 6 combination. Both are very auspicious stars, and it indicates wealth, fame, power, and good health. So this is a very good place to set up important rooms. The next one is South. It's star 4 and 2. The number 4 wood star controls the number 2 earth star, and the power of 2 illness star is reduced by the wood star. And this combination indicates an imbalance of mother-daughter relationship or in-law relationship. And to reduce the number 2 illness star, you can add metal element and avoid construction here. In the southwest is star 6 and 4. The number 6 metal star is controlling the number 4 wood star. The combination indicates power and intelligence, but because they are not tiny star in period 8, we should watch out for illness and relationship trouble, and it might affect the oldest daughter. And we can add water element to balance the energy of metal and wood. Next is the east. It's star 7 and 5. The number 5 is an earth star and generates number 7 metal star. And this combination indicates illness, lawsuit, gossip, and accident. And we can use metal object to reduce the number 5 misfortune star. And we should avoid construction here. In the center is number 9 and 7. The number 9 fire star controls the number 7 metal star. This combination is not lucky for the middle daughter or the younger daughter. And watch out for disease that's related to fire element. For example, the disease related to blood, head, eyes, and so on. And avoid color of red, triangle, or setting up fireplace or stove here, because those belong to the fire element. And we can add earth element here, including the color of yellow, the soil, or ceramic ware to balance the energy of fire and metal. In the west, we have star 2 and 9. The number 9 is a fire star and generates number 2, the earth star. And it indicates money luck, fame, promotion, and offspring luck. So it's generally a good combination, but also watch out for the relationship trouble and possible illness, because number 2 is an illness star. And we can add metal element to reduce the power of the number 2 star. In the northeast is star 3 and 1. The number 1 is a water star, generates number 3 wood star, and it brings wealth, health, fame, but also possible gossip, legal trouble, and money loss. Because the number 3 is related to quarrel, gossip, fighting, and conflicting energy. In the north, we have star 5 and 3. The number 3 is a wood star, and it controls number 5, the earth star. And it indicates illness, accident, business trouble, or money trouble, because the number 5 is a misfortune star. And we can add some metal element to reduce the power of the number 5 star and avoid construction here. The last one is northwest. It's a star combination 1 and 8. And both are very auspicious stars, and both are tiny stars. So it can bring prosperity, fame, wealth, success, and offspring luck. And this is one of the best locations to set up important rooms. This is also a good place to set up a bedroom if you want to increase your chance of having a baby. So that's all the basic charts for the purple-white flying star feng shui. I hope this is helpful for you. Thank you for watching, and talk to you next time.